shot.
Hey, shot. Okay, ready?
How you doing? This is Josh Vivo for DR News. I'm here with some senior girls, and they're going to tell me about Hottie of the Day. Now, Chris, can you tell me how Hottie of the Day got started?
Well, Katie Hatley and I were in second lunch, and one day we noticed that Adam Lass was all dressed up and he looked really good, and we named him Hottie of the Day, and that's how it started.
All right, that's cool. All right, now, Katie, what are the rules to be Hottie of the Day?
Well, you can't have jeans on, and sneakers aren't really good, and no t-shirts. Josh, you're a good everyday hottie of the day.
Yeah, that's right. now, Amanda, you want to tell us how you choose hottie of the day?
Well, first, me, Katie, and Chris come into first lunch, and we think about who we saw during the day that looked good. Then we stand up and we scope one more time, and then we pick, and then we call them over and give them the presentation of hottie of the day.
All right, now, Erin, can you tell us who have been some past hottie of the days?
Danny Texera, Josh Pivo, Dave Castro, Jay Castro, Brian Rosario,
Jeff Stanton
was only freshman, so that's basically it.
Some lucky guys. All right, now, girls, you want to show me what you do? How do you?
Sure.
Pretty interesting stuff.
We have to
school. Let's go.
Nate Tata, we present you with Hottie of the Day.
Thank you very much. This is overwhelming. I'm just so happy that you guys took the time to nominate me. I don't usually dress very nice to school, so I'm really...
Is this your first time, Nate?
Yes, it is, actually, Josh.
Wow, you're lucky.
Wait till my mom hears about this.
Peter, come here, Peter.
Now, here is our runner-up hottie of the day today.
Now, as a freshman, you must feel pretty honored to be runner-up. How do you feel?
Oh, I'm very honored. I mean, this is a big moment for me because since I'm a freshman, I don't get the royalties as the seniors do.
All right, well, you know, maybe next year some girls will take over and you can win a lot more then. I'd like to thank all of you for your time, and we'll see who Hottie of the Day is next day.
Whatever.
Recently, it's come to my attention that there are some students that feel that we are only showing our friends on DR News. Well, we'd like to get as much of the student body on as possible. And if you feel that you have a story that's important enough that we should put on DR News, please come to someone on the show and tell them. We'd be sure to try and get you on as quickly as possible. Thank you.
Monday's blue, Tuesday's gray, and Wednesday too. Thursday, I don't care about you.
Hi, everybody. This is BJ Corey for DR Sports. I'm here with Mr. Palmer, the coach of the boys and girls track teams, and today I'm here to talk to him about the boys track team. Now, Mr. Palmer, how did the boys do this year?
The boys did very well. This is about the fifth year in a row we finished second or third in the league. And we were 6-1 overall this year and finished second to Seekonk.
Okay, now, how long have you been the coach of the track team?
This is my second year as head boys and girls winter track coach and my fifth year as assistant. Previously, Mr. Franzik had been the head coach of both teams.
Okay, now, do you enjoy coaching the winter track?
Yeah, it's rather a unique time of year to run track because we really don't have a facility to train on. Most of our running is done outside every day. We get to do some of the field events inside twice a week, but it poses its special challenges, and it definitely makes it more interesting than the spring in some respects.
Okay, now who were some of the key members on the track team this year?
I think high scorers for the boys team this year were junior John Gendron and sophomore David Muller. I think they both scored around 75 points.
Okay, now were there any certain events at the track meets that you guys were particularly strong in this year?
Yeah, we were pretty solid in almost everything. Our greatest strength came in the sprints, where Gendron and Jay Whedon were very good. John Gendron actually won the league meet in the 50. And probably the distance events, because Coach Marsden's cross-country teams come off the fall so strong, and that always helps us out.
Okay, now last week I talked to Megan Presta, the girls' track captain, and she told me how the meets were scored. Are the boys' meets scored the same way? Or?
Yeah, the boys' meets are scored exactly the same. 5 points for first place in every event, 3 for second, and 1 for third. And then you total up your points against the other teams, and whoever has more points at the end is the winner.
Okay, now where are the winter track meets? Are they all just at New Bedford Volk like the girls? Or?
Yeah, all of our dual meets are at New Bedford Volk. All of our state invitationals and state meets at the end of the year are held at Reggie Lewis in Boston.
Okay, now this year you said you had a pretty good year. Were there any school records that were broken this year for the boys' team?
Yes and no. We actually had one tied. The high jump record of 6'1" was set in 1977, and sophomore Jay Rose equaled that at the league meet this year, jumping 6'1". So his name will go on the board, but the previous name will stay up there also.
Okay, that's very good. Now, did you guys have a relatively young team this year, or was it mainly seniors?
We had pretty good numbers all the way across the board, from freshmen to seniors. So we'll be about the same next year as we were this year. We'll be pretty solid all the way around.
Okay, so what are your expectations for the team for next year?
As general goals, I would like to see the team increase in numbers. We had 40 this year, which was 5 more than the previous year. I'd like, you know, maybe get 45. I think the more kids that do a sport, that's the true success of a sport, in giving numbers of kids a chance to compete. As far as finishing second, I'd be happy with that again.
Okay, well, I wish you the best of luck, and I'd like to thank you for the interview.
Appreciate your time, BJ. Thank you.
Okay, thanks. The boys' track team had another successful season. They were 6-1 and finished second place in the SCC. They had a school record tied this year, and I'd like to thank Mr. Palmer for his time for the interview, and we'll be back next week.
Now, who's hot, who not? Tell me who rock, who sell out in the stores. You tell me who flop, who cop the blue drop, who jewels got blocks, who mostly goes down to the blue drop. The same.
I have an interesting story for you all about a certain student athlete. Her name is Christine Alves, and Christine is, surprisingly as it may sound, a lumberjack. She couldn't be here for an interview today, but I talked to her earlier, and I learned quite a bit about her favorite pastime. Christine's parents got her into it about 4 years ago, and she's been competing in lumberjacking shows for about a year. Christine competes in axe throwing, where a contestant stands at a distance from a target, tries to hit that target. She competes in Jack and Jill cross-cutting, where two people using a really big saw cut a log in half. And log rolling, where someone balances themselves on a log and sees how far they can get rolling it along the ground. These competitions are held all over the world, but Christine is strictly a New England lumberjack, competing in Warner, New Hampshire, Brooklyn, Connecticut, Portsmouth, New Hampshire, Sharon Springs, Vermont, and Westport. In practicing for a competition, she says, there isn't really much you can do. You just have to try to work out at home and keep your muscles loose so you don't pull anything. Christine's won 2 awards already in her first year of lumberjacking, attaining 6th place in axe throwing and 2nd in Jack and Jill cross-cutting. This is a seasonal sport. It started up at the end of May and continuing on until late September. Christine is ready for next season, and hopefully, she says, she'll be into Class A stock chainsaws. Christine, you do Dighton Rehoboth proud. We salute you.
Run back to take in the VCO. I'm coming, baby, like the big black kahuna. I wish you would be just a little sooner. So now rich like silver spooner. Spooner, now here's the... Now I got your moon.
body hit the